Hi, I am Dr. Shankumar B. Patil, Professor, Sai Vidya Institute of Technology, Bangalore. Today I am going to explain how to model data warehouse by using the different schemas. The entity relationship data model is commonly used in design of relational databases, consists of a set of entity and their relationship. Such a data model is appropriate for online transaction processing, OLTP. Whereas in data warehouse, OLAP is used to analyze the data. Hence, data is arranged in the form of cube. A lattice of cuboid shown in figure are arranged in the form of dimension and hierarchical fashion so that it will be easy for analysis. They are arranged in the form of the zero dimensional, one dimensional like a time, item, location, supplier, 2D. So each node in the cuboid consists of two items, time and item, time and location, like that 3D, 4D. To model data warehouse, star schemas, snowflake schema, and packed constellations are used. The most commonly used schema is star schema, in which data warehouse contains a large central table called packed table, contains bulk of data with no redundancy. A set of smaller attendant tables called dimension table, one for each dimension. The schema graph resembles a starburst with dimension tables displayed in a radial pattern around the central packed table. In figure, there are four dimensions: time, item, branch, location. The schema contains a central fact table for sales that contains foreign key to each of the four dimensions along with two measures, dollars sold and unit sold. Notice that in star schema, each dimension is represented by only one table, and each table contains a set of attributes. Snowflake schema is a variant of star schema model where some dimension table are normalized, thereby further splitting data into additional tables. The resulting schema graph forms a shape similar to a snowflake. The major difference between star and snowflake model is that the dimension tables of snowflake model may be kept in normalized form to reduce redundancies. Such a table is easy to maintain and saves storage space. However, this space is saving is negligible in comparison to the typical magnitude of the packed table. Further, the snowflake structure can reduce the effectiveness of browsing since more joints are needed to execute a query. Consequently, system performance may be adversely impacted. Hence, although Snowflake schema reduces redundancy, it is not as popular as the star schema in data warehouse design. The single dimension per item in the star schema is normalized in the Snowflake schema, resulting in new item and supplier tables. For example, the item dimension table now contains attribute item key, item name, brand type, and supplier key, where supplier key is linked to supplier dimension table containing supplier key and supplier type information. Fact constellation, this schema specifies two fact tables, sales and shipping. The sales table is identical to star schema. The shipping table has five dimensions: item key, time key, shipper key, from location and to location, and two measures: dollars cost and units shipped. A fact constellation schema allows dimension tables to be shared between fact tables. For example, dimension table for time, item, and locations are shared between the sales and shipping fact table. So these are the some of the schemas are used in the data warehouse modeling. Thank you.